Hi everyone! In this video, I'll show you how to install GLPI 11 on Ubuntu or Debian, an open source platform that helps you manage IT assets, users, and support tickets efficiently. First, make sure your LAMP stack is installed on your system. Now, let's check the status of the Apache service to make sure it's running properly. If you see active running, it means Apache is working fine. Just like Apache, let's check the MySQL or MariaDB service to make sure it's running. Next, let's check the PHP version installed on your system, since GLPI 11 requires 8 Philippine pesos and 20 centavos or higher to run properly. Next, let's update your package list and system to make sure everything is up to date before installing GLPI. Next, let's install the required PHP extension so GLPI 11 can run smoothly with all its features. Next, let's create a database for GLPI. First, log in to MariaDB as root. I have prepared a sample script here. You just need to replace the database name, username, and password with your own values. Then copy and run these commands one by one inside the MariaDB shell. After creating the database, the next step is to download the latest version of GLPI from the official website. First, let's move into the Apache web root directory, where we'll deploy the GLPI files. Next, we'll get the download link for the latest GLPI version from the official website. Make sure to select the latest release. This is the most stable and recommended version of GLPI for production environments. Next, right-click on the file, then select Copy Link to copy the direct download URL. Once the download is complete, we'll extract the GLPI installation package. After extracting, you'll see a new folder named GLPI. If you prefer, you can rename this folder to something easier to manage. Next, we'll set the proper permissions for Apache so the web server can read and write inside the GLPI directory. After setting the permissions, you'll see something like this. That means the permissions for the GLPI folder have been applied successfully. Next, we'll create a dedicated virtual host for GLPI. This helps Apache organize and manage your websites more efficiently, and it also allows you to access GLPI through a custom domain or subdomain if you like. Now we'll add the sample configuration I've prepared here. On the server name line, enter your server's IP address, or your domain or subdomain if you already have one configured. On the document root line, note that this is the path to the GLPI source directory we extracted earlier. On the alias line, if you keep it like this, you'll access GLPI through your server's IP or domain, followed by GLPI. After editing, save and exit the configuration file. Next, we'll enable the new virtual host for GLPI. We also need to enable the Apache Rewrite module to support dynamic URLs in GLPI. Then reload Apache to apply the changes. With the Apache configuration and required modules in place, we can now proceed to the GLPI setup through the web interface. On the first screen of GLPI, click on Go to Install page to start the installation process. Select Install to start a fresh GLPI installation. If all the requirements show as OK, that means your server fully meets the installation requirements for GLPI. Here, enter localhost in the SQL server field, since our database is hosted on the same server. Next, in the SQL user and password fields, enter the database username and password that you created earlier for GLPI. Then, click Continue to proceed to the next step. Next, select the database we created earlier for GLPI, and then click Continue to move on with the installation. Here, you'll see that the system has automatically created default accounts and passwords. The GLPI account is the main administrator account. Now, let's log in using the GLPI account and the default password provided by the system to access the GLPI administration dashboard. So we have successfully completed the installation of GLPI 11 on Ubuntu or Debian. In the next videos, we'll learn how to set up GLPI Agent on both Windows and Linux to automatically collect hardware information and improve asset management. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share to support the channel.